I'm Philippe François, I'm a good teacher, and a beginning civic agent. I was a member of the section to promote agility in Toulouse. And I use Eclipse CP for a product of CECOM and its clients since 3 years. Philippe is my sponsor of the project I present today, GNSS. A full info application for our GNSS engine. You can interact with Philippe and me by Twitter using the hashtag e4scrum in GNSS. Can I ask you if you know the GNSS problematic? No? Yes? It's the use of the GPS for the localization, co-localization. GPS is the American solution, we have also a Russian solution and a European solution. We are friends with the agility process. Okay. I talk about agility a little bit during this presentation. And the rest of the presentation is on the e-force application. E-force application. My second in few words. It's a private engineering company, Knowledge Phones, 13 years of experiences into electronic GNSS and hard software development. Our domains are aeronautics and space. I won't spend a lot of time on this. What is the GNSS laboratory? If you are an industrial, you want to guarantee your quality of service according to the constellation geometry, number of satellites in the visibility, the propagation effect of the signal sent by the satellites, and the type of satellites used for your localization. And at the end, of course, the quality of your receiver. Okay. If you take an iPhone, the GNSS localization is not very good, but it's not the main objective of your iPhone. Guy, in my client, it's a French center of excellence for education and technology for satellite navigation. Why? It's a GNSS laboratory shared by 13 actors of the French GNSS industry. Okay. Yes, we have Telespatio, Maxi, CS, Indéo, ENAC, Thales, Capgemini, Optal, Metrodes, Silicon, Italy. Why? Because it's very difficult to test in America the GNSS receiver, and we need a lot of tools for this. So we make an association guide for promote laboratory. We can help all industrial in the GNSS industry to test and develop our solutions. The laboratory test is composed of four zones up to the normal zone where we can use a car to test your receiver. At the tax, an aero zone, you can test a receiver into a helicopter or drone. High accuracy area where we can test your receiver on a highway position with an accuracy of less than the centimeter position. Okay.
Sorry, the animation is out.
We have here we have the remote solution. And back, you have the car, the boat. our receiver. We have a large set of data collected by each different card, each different carrier. We want a simple application because our GNSS engineer doesn't want to spend much more time to use the application. We want to be open for future analysis because at this time we don't know what kind of analysis we need for the next client we can have. And we want to register all equipment using by test because at the end of the test we shall produce a certificate. Okay. That is my GNSS technical domains. But what do I do in this? Why do I do it? Make a review.
Practice of testing for the preparation of Next.
What is our challenge? Our challenge is to first we want to change the E3 solution because E3 is too easy. Because we have a big backbone of E3 solution in application development. For me, I think E3 is a little bit difficult to maintain. It's not very friendly for the graphical development. Secondly, I want to kernel competence for E3 application development. So now, with the JL data property, we can do the trade-off between E3 and E4 solution. We can estimate the E4 solution. And we can identify the solution constraints for the E4 solution. Okay. And so we want to test the E4 solution in a real case, not a book or a bar application, but a real product into a product suite. Guide is composed of three applications, JSON. Related product. The campaign, the E3 application, and JData, the E4 application. We want to test E4 in real case, and with JData and GAN, we have a maintenance feedback. Actually, we have 3 months of feedback, and we have a lot of end-user feedback because with the 30 enterprise guide, we have a lot of feedback right by the system users. The challenge of JData, first, E4 is based on a full EMF model for our application. Before I use the JSON, dependency injection, and provide an API for annotation rather than by inheritance like E3 and is a part of editor part. The dependency injection with the annotation RWBAS inject was well presented last year at the Boston EclipseCon, and you can find the presentation of EclipseCon on the site of the EclipseCon. At the end of the presentation, I give you all links according to this presentation. By annotation in E4 provide view and editors. The by annotation before make view and editors become simple like a Cojo and give you no dependency to view part or editor part. Others specific challenge in E4 is the use of annotation for services, the dependency of a JSON allow you to easy access to a wide range of services like the e-selection service, the e-model services, access to the application model, etc. The life cycle of a user will be defined by annotation too, with annotation ORAS. Post-construct, focus, persist. It's very different from E3. But I think it's a bit close to the editor between E3 and E4 because the editor for lifecycle is managed by default in E3. And you must redefine it with annotation in E4, for example. The uniqueness of an editor for a given resource is quite easy with E3 and high editor input. I don't know what happens with this presentation. It's not very easy.
So the weakness of the editor is given for given resource in this read is an editor input. We use it as this interface and it's easy to make. But I had to implement it with it for. It's not very different. This is the XME model, the application model. So in default, our application model is given by the XME file. The application model is described by the structure of the will describe the structure of the application. Application, windows, perspective, handlers. The force model is completely defined by PMF. It's easy to, for a developer with PMF knowledge to take it take on this application. It's also very easy to maintain this application. The structure of the application is technically defined in XME file. And the model application will then be able to manipulate to manipulate at one time to extend or modify the application. The frame mount, for example, the frame mount is also XME file. You can extend the application. Another one about the application model and the handler. Here I select my handler for the quick command and I define the handler. Just a tip. Take a key space into your own configuration if you want to take to make the change of the XME to take into account when you run the another configuration. If you don't tick this tip, all modification of your XME doesn't take into account. Sometimes it's difficult to understand. Now, a simple example of dependency injection. What is my shell? If you take the simplest sample of the shell with this read, we have a lot of interface to use a shell. And there's a seal, get activity, active shell, get sign, get shell, platform UI, what is the best solution? What is the more obvious? Why did you do this?
I can't answer.
It depends on the conditions. Probably it could be difficult to maintain this code. VC4 and the IOC design, we can quickly and painfulness access to the shell. Two annotation, inject, and any ISX constant active shell. Next is the NTO. For GAD application, all business objects come from the MF Licor model. What do we need? Some of them are sent into file because the user required to move quickly and simply data from a DO2 to another. Other shall be saved and shared into a database. So we use CNEO and TNEO because they are today a mature technology to secure and share the MF models into a database. It is easy to navigate from a resource into XME file to resource into the database. It enables to share the instrument base between all seats, to lose the IS, etc. It's able to concurrent access to the data lab and send to the client automatic notification. I can do a little demonstration of the application if you want.
And give some results, but we can introduce into test report produced by GCamp E3 application. Why are you using E3 application? Because you doesn't want to use E4 application for all the application in order to not take too much risk. But we are really satisfied by the E4 solution for this problem. So we can speak about the trade-off of the E4 solution. You have some questions, and if you want have the links of the presentation is saved on the EclipseCon site. Yes, one conclusion, I use the roti and we can put trade-off with the roti between the E3 and E4 solution. Integration is very good. confirm with the same same method. We use an applet fan and inject the G3 shards and pin it. No problem.
User question on GNSS, Agility or for solution? So if I'm in English. If you have some question in French after.